Charlie, can you look at me and say Merry Christmas, Daddy?
Merry Christmas, Daddy.
You know, for me, being a father was the most important thing in my life, was to be a good dad.
Hi.
Thank you.
We're in the snow.
I always remember when I was a little girl that I couldn't wait to have kids, and we're very blessed to have these children.
Happy Halloween 2000.
Charlie was a very easy baby.
What are you going to be for Halloween, Charlie?
Batman.
Cool.
He was happy, had a great laugh.
Charlie was about to graduate, and he was in love, and it was like we were almost ready to high-five and say, well done, we did it. We raised great young people and sent them off into the world. And 3 weeks before he's supposed to graduate, it just exploded.
All right, we'll go to his room.
Even though he's gone, we talk
he's
about
not.
Him, but he's not.
Yeah.
I mean, I still have his clothes in here.
Oh, man.
And I smell him.
What happened? In 2018, Charlie was 20 when he hurt his back.
He was prescribed Percocet at the time of his surgery. Yeah. Took it while the prescription lasted and then stopped.
Then in 2020, he heads back to school.
He called us and told us his back was hurting. And we said, call your doctor.
Well, somebody knows somebody on Snapchat that he's got some pills from before. So they look at the menu and Charlie says, oh, look, he's got Percs too. What we put together is that he took what he thought was a Percocet, but turned out to be a counterfeit.
Is it the belief that he died within 30 minutes of taking that pill?
Probably less than that.
The doctors concluded from that he did not have a tolerance to opioids at the time of his death, so he wasn't addicted or dependent.
It was a poisoning.
It was a poisoning because of the deception. A counterfeit prescription pill where the only active ingredient is fentanyl. There's certain dangers that we have in the back of our minds that we want to protect our kids from, but a counterfeit prescription pill wasn't on that list.
I have two young kids, and I, like every parent, worry about keeping them safe every day. But fentanyl is a synthetic opioid 100 times stronger than morphine. The size of just a few grains of salt can be enough to kill an average adult man. So a lethal dose of fentanyl could be in any counterfeit pill. And that's why Ed and Mary Ternan decided to tackle this problem in a new way after they lost their son. They established Song for Charlie with the sole purpose of warning young people and their parents that one pill can kill.
If it's not from a doctor or pharmacist, it's not legit.
We started our first campaign about a year ago, a social media campaign, and in just a year, we have reached 52 million unique viewers. And that's really where we're laser focused, is to reach them where they are and to warn them.
Hi, guys.
We have made dozens of presentations to school assemblies and in school classrooms and in community groups. We have a monthly awareness meeting.
Rick and I lost our son, Logan, last year.
We are at Times Square.
I can tell you there's a lot more awareness now.
Where we co-sponsored a billboard
2 years after Charlie's death than there was when we started.
What are some of your favorite memories with Charlie here?
Seeing him try to figure out how to body surf,
yeah.
Right?
The fact that your story, Charlie's story, through you, is now saving lives. What do you think Charlie would think about all of this, about these beautiful agents of change that you have become?
I think he'd be very proud. And he'd be hugging us.
Mm.
And he is hugging us. He knows that we're doing good work on his behalf.